Throughout time, people across the world told each other tales of how they came to be. Of heroes and monsters, romance and tragedy, death and rebirth. Mythology helped shape the ancient world, explaining the unexplainable. This is Mythology Unleashed. In honor of Black History Month, we here at Mythology Unleashed celebrate by telling the legend of John Henry, a steel-driven man of immense strength, surpassed only by the power of his heart. Without further ado, here is Dani Burke with a legend of John Henry.
Thunder and lightning filled the southern skies. The world was welcoming the arrival of a legend. On that stormy night in the late 1800s, John Henry was born to an enslaved family who gazed in wide wonder at the child they had brought into the world. Even as a newborn baby, John was larger and stronger than any baby anyone had ever seen, strong enough to hold his father's hammer in just one hand. And John would continue to grow every day at an unnatural rate. There were days where he would put on clothes that fit in the morning, and by day's end he was just too big for them. Growing up enslaved, he labored from sunrise to sunset, never having a moment's pause. This immense workload, combined with his preternatural growth, led to John's already great strength growing exponentially. By the time he had reached adulthood, he was nearly 7 feet tall and the strongest man who'd ever lived. Although his physical brawn was unmatched by other people, it was truly only surpassed by the power of his heart. He would give the shirt off his back for someone in need, and he had a warm glow about him that others would flock to. Indeed, John Henry was strong and bold, with a heart of gold. Following the signing of the Emancipation Proclamation, most enslaved people of America were freed from their bonds of servitude, and John, with his wife Polly and young son, went off to find work. John found work as a steel-driving man for the Chesapeake and Ohio Railroad Company. The C&O Railroad endeavored to extend the railroad through the Allegheny Mountains of West Virginia, from Chesapeake Bay to the Ohio Valley. It was long and strenuous work, full of hazardous conditions with extremely low pay. But under John's leadership, the workers made an incredible time. The project progressed smoothly until they came to the steps of Big Bend Mountain. It was too large to build around the mountain, so the C&O Railroad decided to dig through it. So John and nearly 1,000 workers toiled, seemingly unendlessly, digging a tunnel nearly a mile long. With falling rocks and airborne dust all around, many workers would fall ill or die from the workload and dangerous conditions. With their numbers dwindling and the remainder slowing down, John Henry took 2 14-pound hammers and barreled through the mountain. John's strength, speed, and endurance proved mighty, but his real power came from the indomitable will and the love he had for the people around him. As the heat raged on and John Henry toiled in the mountain, the company was approached by a salesman who pitched to them a new invention, the steam drill. The steam drill was said to be able to do the work of 12 men, and they would be absolved of having to pay workers or deal with human error. The company was excited about this new machine, but the foreman scoffed at the salesman's offer, for John Henry was more than a match for any machine. So a challenge was laid. If John could defeat the steam drill in a race, the salesman would give the company the drill for free. When John looked at the machine, he saw a glimpse of a terrible future, images of himself, his family, and friends being replaced by steam and metal, left unemployed and homeless. Many of his co-workers who were once enslaved like himself would lose their newfound freedom. John accepted the challenge. He had to stand tall for everyone who worked on the railroad. His friends and co-workers all cheered, though Polly was worried for her husband, for as mighty as he was, he was still a man, going up against a machine. At dawn, John Henry lined up with the steam drill, a hammer in each hand. At the sound of a pistol, John swung his hammers with all his might. The race had begun. John and the drill raced for hours, The rumbling nearly caused an earthquake. The dust clouded the tunnel so thick, the spectators could only hear the sound of thunder and see the lightning flashes of John's hammer. Suddenly, a huge crash was heard, and the steam drill was pulled from the tunnel, having broken down from extreme stress. But the sounds of thunder and flashes of lightning continued from the tunnel. John Henry was still working. Polly and the others tried to go in and tell him he had won, but the dust fumes were too thick, and John was moving further and further away. When the dust finally cleared, John had tunneled all the way through the mountain. But alas, it was too much for even him. His heart had given out, and he fell to the ground. Everyone gathered around their fallen hero, heads bowed and hats removed, as Polly cradled her dying husband. John then looked up at his wife and smiled as he drew his final breath, his hammer still in his hand.